In a previous video, we looked at this Hamilton high power USB charging socket, and we thought, how did they manage to cram 45 watts of charging power into a double socket? So in this video, we're going to take a closer look inside. Right, glasses first, can I give you the old Roy Orbitons there?
Thank you.
Right, just got to take the two rivets off the front that hold the earth bar in place.
Come off neatly. We'll look at the first attempt in a minute. Yeah, while you're trying to get that one off. Okay, so just notice the speedy out the corner of my eye, bringing that in as well.
Always like to get the speedy out. Different coloured it in there. I think the plastic with it there. So. Oh, nearly there. Hold on. Nope, a bit further on that one.
A little bit more, yeah. We went a bit aggressive there, weren't we? Just have a quick look while you're on.
Yeah, that's one we did earlier. Mm. One we destroyed earlier. Right, speed Ian. Regular viewers to the channel may notice we're in a different part of the building now for this teardown. And Gary thinks the actual floor slopes. I just think he looks smaller because he's getting old and he's shrinking.
Okay. The outlet for the water to run down is in this corner, and I've got a funny feeling it always slopes down to that area.
I don't see any taps. Six screws on this to hold it in. Okay. I don't recommend doing this at home.
What, using the speedy? I don't recommend it at all. Okay. Yeah, a little look. A little bit more, yeah.
Using a technical.
One of your older screwdrivers, isn't it?
No, it's one of yours.
Popped off. Right.
Right, here we go. So this is the bit where it depends on where the bits do the nest in the front. If I remember on the last Hamilton one, everything sits on the back.
Okay.
So then if I lift the front off, bingo. So just before we lose that, we'll see that there's our switch mechanism and the springs for the shutter.
Okay.
We'll notice the...
It's got a whiff of being well engineered straight away, hasn't it? Look at that.
Yeah, it's a neat injection moulding. So first thing, this looks to be single pole, which sort of shows you one of the first way they've done this.
There's a lot of room been taken up as well, and they have got a lot of stuff in there, haven't they?
Yeah. So there's our shutters. We'll remove them from the socket. Yeah, so look here, here's the switch. So that, without the mechanism in it, it's just there. You can see, so that they're actually single pole, where normally we used to see in sockets as double pole, but something's obviously had to give to get...
A little bit of compromise there, isn't there?
Yeah, and if we trace that back out, so there we can see the neutral... Back up to that terminal there. How does it find its way across to the neutral? Ah, it sort of leaves the socket contact there.
Yeah.
Wanders down there, around up behind the live, and into there.
That is, yeah, good engineering again, isn't it?
Yeah.
We've used every available millimetre.
So what we'll try and do is ping those bits out. So that's part of the live. And part of the live there. So here's our USB. Power supply in the middle. So the interesting thing is, obviously what you worry about in power supplies is isolation between the primary and the secondary. So here's the line connection made there, and the neutral, you see, just soldered onto there.
Yep.
Drops into the primary of the power supply. It's got a fuse there. We've got a little bit of surge protection. We've got an EMC filter on the front end of our power supply. And these are high frequency transformers. So always worry about getting the right isolation between primary and secondary. We can see we've got double insulated wire coming off there onto the low voltage side, which wanders out to our USB sockets. You can just see how much room we've had to create in the socket to do that. So again, oh, that's good. So these look like thermal transfer pads when you normally see these. So yeah, so they sit under some of the components to get hot. Obviously at 45 watts, we have got some power to dissipate, and they've got a thermal transfer pad in there to do that. So this sticks onto the components on there, and so it's like a sort of putty substance. Obviously helps transfer the heat to the outside of the unit. So again, we can see there's the protection between the primary and the secondary sides to give us the required level of voltage isolation between them. There's actually quite a bit of electronics in there. Yes, that's quite a neat little unit.
I think this is a really well-engineered solution by Hamilton. And on the back here is all the marks you'd expect to see with in relation to the British standards it complies to. But ultimately, that comes down to trusting the manufacturer. And we do trust Hamilton. I've even got one of these predecessors to this installed at home, and it's still working, which is always good. But some people we don't trust, Gary.
No, we don't. And we did another tear down on something we called the Universally Dangerous Socket Outlet. If you want to check out that video, it's over there.